Alright everybody,
I'm doing some maintenance on my machines here, and this is one I've been particularly interested in getting back into here, because I feel like it might have some potential for certain uses. So today we're going to be cracking open my HP Pavilion 552X mid-tower from 2002. I've made a couple vids showing this thing, in which I mentioned this. I made one showcase video on it about 3 years ago, almost 3.5 years ago. So I'm just going to clean this thing, or at least inspect it, because it could use it. I want to see just how bad it is. I don't have a whole lot yet in terms of cleaning tools. Try with what I have. I'm gonna get some compressed air if I need it, canned air. Oh, dirty here. I can pull this thing off though. Look at that. Oh, I don't know if I ever showed this in a pickups video, but I got Oblivion for the PC. I got that in April of 2017. So I don't know if I ever showed that in a pickups video, but I've always had that. Wow, look at that, it's pretty bad. It's coming up though. I'm not sure if I'm going to spend a whole hell of a lot of time on this. Yeah, the things for this broke a long time ago. So it just kind of sits on there. A lot of times if I turn it on its side or whatever, it just falls right off, which isn't really surprising. But just kind of a cheapo part, but it is a neat idea to be able to store some disks on top of your computer, which, I mean, I make use of that. I used to have more disks in there, but I've taken some of them out. But I don't mind having that space. Don't mind at all. I never really did clean this part out particularly well, which is why this is still in here. Some hair in here. It's big, long hair, which I'm gonna vacuum this anyway, so it's not a big problem. The dust's gonna get blown around anyway, so it is what it is. There's still some of that nasty stuff along here. I'm sorry if you can see my hair is a mess right now, but it is what it is. Just wanted to get this done because somebody else is in the shower right now, so otherwise I'd be in there. Let's see. I think it's good enough, really. I don't come in here often, and as long as the actual disc part of it's clean. I don't take the top off because it still goes back. It's just that there's nothing to hold it there, so I usually just do that. So no real need to clean it other than for it to look better, but this tower gets really dirty easily. These are a little bit dirty. They're very dirty actually. It's almost like somebody spilled soda on that. I don't know if you can tell. So I'm going to clean the sides off. Also, it's cracked on the inside. I don't know if it was always like that, but you never know. I could have done that at some point. Wow. Yeah, it's really like, honestly, that's from me. That is from me. This whole thing is from me. I spilled pop on this once, now that I remember it, a long time ago. I spilled pop on this computer all over my desk, and it got on the computer. And so I just never cleaned it. So now this is for me. Now that I think about it. Yeah. So good to clean it up. Give it a new lease on life, hopefully. I think that's good enough for now, though. But that's probably also due to the pop. But I'm just going to actually leave this off because it's going to fall off anyway. front, so you can see the front. It's just dusty and dirty, because I don't see the front of this computer, because the back is facing the, it's facing outward, so the front's covered. So getting a disc in this thing is kind of annoying. It is discoloring. I can tell that it's discolored because it's facing a window now. It wasn't that bad when I got it. But welcome to plastic. Old plastic, so. I've done some work on this computer before. I've upgraded it. I put in, this is taped over here because these are broken. This one though, I put a new drive in it. I put a new DVD drive into that thing. And then up here I think is the CD drive that came with the computer, but it broke. But I don't have any need for the second slot, so I haven't done anything with it. To get to these slots is a pain because the whole thing has to come apart. The whole thing has to come apart because you got to take the front plate off. My USBs here are pretty clean. Looks good. The bottom of it, it's missing the feet. It's been missing the feet. Let me see if there's any interesting information on the bottom here. Yeah, it's all fading away. These feet are kind of nasty, but I'm not sure if I can even really do much about that. I don't really want this to be. I don't need the stickies anymore. I haven't even gotten on the inside yet. But yeah, I've done some work to this computer. I mentioned that in my video on it. I might put that in the description, the video that I made on this tower. I've done some more software installs since then. But this tower has some problems, which is part of why I don't use it. Because it's actually a fairly capable computer for basic things that are offline. There's no problem with it. Power-wise, for me, I tried to make it a decent mid-2000s gaming machine, but I just don't think it's possible. It has a Pentium 4 in it, which is part of the problem. And, it has AGP. So that doesn't make it easy to get a good video card. Get model 552X and my serial number, which I don't know if there's any information. This is pretty dirty on the side here. I don't know how exactly that happened. Probably from the pop spill. But we'll take care of that. I got this in November of 2017. And it came with a Microsoft mouse, Microsoft IntelliMouse. That was like a silver one. It was one of their earlier USB ones, and it had these rubber buttons that got extremely sticky. I still have that somewhere. It's outside of the room, but I still do have it. And it came with a HP X20 LED monitor, 20-inch 16x9 monitor, which is a mediocre screen, but at the time it was nice for me because I didn't have a large monitor at all back then. I was only using a 15-inch gateway monitor, which I still have sitting on my desk. Although it's mostly been replaced by my 24-inch Dell monitor. But for these older machines, I don't like to drive anything huge on them, just because, especially for games, the performance takes a massive hit. So there's a bit here that I'm having a hard time getting off. The rest of this came pretty easy, though, which is good. Come on, buddy. You're so close. Yeah, you can check out my other video for specs on this guy. It has like a 40 gig hard drive. I don't know if I mentioned that in the video. I don't think that drive is actually going bad, it's just slow. The CMOS battery is dead in it, though. Which I guess isn't too surprising. However, it's dead in a weird way. You can see my video card right there. It has DVI, S-Video, VGA. So I'm not using the onboard anymore. This seems alright. Those fans could use a bit of cleaning, but they're not bad. That's the power supply fans, though, so I'm probably not going to do much other than blow some air into that, but let me get this off. But, I was starting to say something here, but I forgot. Wow, I forgot what I was going to say. These thumb screws are a bit tight. There's not much reason to take off the other side because the other side for this you only want to take off if you're going to take the front plate off, otherwise there's no need. So let's crack it over here. Hopefully you can see this pretty well. I'm trying to do my best with this vid. First thing I would like to do is take this plastic shroud off over the CPU fan. Not bad. Not bad at all. There's some dust along there. Decent bit of dust along that, but that's just probably old dust that I never took care of. My GPU, wish I had a flashlight. Wish I could see that. It's a Radeon. All I know is that it's a Radeon card. It's like a 256 meg Radeon card. 9550, I think. I'd have to look. RAMs, it's got like 768 mega RAM. I ordered more RAM for it, but it wasn't compatible with the... I don't even think it was compatible with the computer itself. Either that or it wasn't compatible with my setup, my existing RAM setup. So I still have that RAM in its package to this day. I put it back in and it never came out. I'm just kind of lightly cleaning this, but there's not much dust on it at all. Surprisingly, this thing did not accumulate much at all. There's a bit, but not too bad. Now, I would do best to redo the thermal paste on this computer and completely wash this fan. But this fan, I think it works fine still. I don't see any reason why it shouldn't. Just a matter of thermal performance, though, from the thermal paste. I'm not concerned about this fan. The bearings are still good, as far as I can tell. It's not that dirty. I'm not getting much dust off of this thing. So it's spinning fine. It's just a matter of the thermal paste. But it's not bad, actually. There is a bit of dust. Probably old dust in here. You should have seen this thing when I first opened it the very first time. Yeah, there you go. Oh yeah, this is definitely going to be a bit more of a necessary clean. But you should have seen this thing the first time I opened it. There were just big black balls of dust or pet hair or whatever the hell it was that I had going on there. But I had a different rug back then. You probably know what that looks like if you watch my older videos. It's similar color, but a different pattern. And that rug was just black in areas after I was messing with this thing. Just from turning it over, that thing went black. So yeah, it was pretty bad. I need to blow this out. I need to do a little bit more for this fan, but it's not horrible. I got some clumps out that were in there already, which will help.
It's not bad, though. It's really not too bad.
Use a Q-tip.
See if I can just get some dust out of that. Yeah, I can. Good.
Oh yeah, that's pretty good.
Some caps around here though. Caps don't look bad on this board, which is nice.
Wow, yes, that's some of the original dust that was in there when I first got this guy. I don't have another Q-tip around, so let me just see if I can... Nah, alright. I could probably go get more, though, if I wanted to, but
I think that'll be fine for now. That's my battery. Let's see if I can remove the battery easily. My nails are pretty short right now, so it's kind of hard to
hold that guy. I don't think there's really anything holding it down, though, because I don't see
a clamp or a...
There's no clamp.
Let me see. The only thing there is this little small guy, but it's not... I'll just deal with that later.
Yeah. And there's the hard drive. This is the floppy. This is the hard drive right there. And I got a P3 connector. And this is the P5 connector for the power for the drive right there. And that's a 40 gig IDE drive. It's upside down, but that's that drive. I can unplug these. Yeah, this thing is missing some screws, this drive, from when I was messing with this one time, when I got the front off of it to take these guys out.
Yeah, this is a pretty big mess here, but that's, to do RAM in this thing, I know my wiring's pretty bad in this computer,
and then there's your power connector for your floppy, I'm not going to take that out. But to do the RAM in this computer, to get to those other ones, man, it's a bitch. Because you kind of have to disconnect the slave for the bottom drive if you have it connected. You got to completely disconnect that. And then you can reach down through more wires and get those cards to pop up. But it's kind of a mess, so. But I'm not going to be reseating the RAMs in this guy. I'm just going to kind of push down on them. Reseating the RAMs on this computer is pretty annoying, because of what I just mentioned. But it's doable. If you have to swap your RAM out, you can do it. This is that bottom. This is the good drive. And it's my P5 and my P3. I'm not using the P3, I don't think. But they're about the same. I don't mean this. I don't think there's any diff. I don't know if there is a difference between the P3 and the P4, P5. I'm pretty sure my P5 was in here to start with. I don't think I was using this one. Master. That's the FDD, it's a floppy disk drive. However, I should have done this in a different order. Yeah, I don't need to have these disconnected. I was just doing it to show. I don't know how well you can see this either. But yeah, the RAM upgrade on this guy isn't that easy compared to my other Pavilion computer. Okay. Sure, that's good.
I'm gonna make sure you're not pinching any wires. P5. Can go in after that. Otherwise, you're gonna have a hard time getting that on. And FDD. Also, is missing a screw.
But that drive is loose.
I'm missing a screw there. I'll have to look and see if I can find any screw that fit that. Probably can. I have a lot of screws. But, because that's not good.
I might swap this drive out, though, at some point. The only problem for me is reloading the operating system. Because this hard drive does have a partition to reload the operating system, and it activates it. I didn't have to do anything to mess with that. It was an OEM activation. If this were a Dell, I wouldn't be afraid at all of that. But it's not a Dell, so gotta deal with that. This shroud is pretty clean, actually. I'll kind of wipe it down, though. The shroud was just caked in dust when I got it. Unbelievable. The whole computer was just a mess. Obviously, nobody had been inside that thing before. Because I did all the upgrades myself. So. I might invest in a better video card for it, though. See what the best AGP video card is that I can find that's compatible. Maybe it'll give me a better chance, but I feel like I just don't feel like I can get much faster with this computer. I feel like it kind of is where it is. So, some hair there. So a little bit of. I plan to use this computer for some stuff. I want to see if I can make videos on this computer with my Logitech webcam. So if I can get the older software on this computer, that'd be really nice. I have Mach 3 installed on this computer, because you don't need much for Mach 3. Just you need a desktop and not a laptop. And this is my only other Windows desktop. Other than my old 6640C, which is just not enough anymore for that, even, so. But a Pentium 4 for Mach 3, I don't see any problem there. So, I make sure that the shroud can fit down there, because it's just a mess. I think I got it. And the cleanouts are here. So. Yeah. That's that plastic shroud that I was talking about. I'm gonna come back to this. It doesn't look too bad on the inside. Not much worse than when I got it, so it's probably better now than it was even the last time I cleaned it. So, I took care of that pop spill, though, which is good. But the only thing that I gotta find out, I'd like to swap that battery out. I'd hopefully like to get a bigger hard drive in this guy at some point. But the big thing is, I'm just going to have to start using this guy again. Because I've had a couple instances of it restarting on its own. If it's going to do that often, then obviously it's I got to figure out what the hell's wrong with that. Because you can't be doing that. The thing is, like, the operating system just restarts. The computer, there is no indication that the computer itself is doing anything. It's just the operating system is restarting itself. The computer never powers off, the fans never stop running, doesn't make any noises whatsoever, it just restarts. So, that's what I gotta figure out. Because if that is not an issue, then I'm good to move forward with this guy. I had a hard time with this video card, but it seems to be working good now. I got Oblivion on this guy. which I think I've mentioned in some other vids, that I was able to play Oblivion on this computer, albeit extremely poorly, but I didn't have to install old Oblivion or anything like that to play it, which is cool. I don't think this computer would ever be a good Oblivion computer. I just don't think you can upgrade it enough to do so. I would consider building a more mid-late 2000s tower, but I just need to find a good base for it, and I've always been so distracted by other stuff that I never got to looking into doing that, or to acquiring parts or anything like that. It would be nice, though. Probably put Windows XP and Windows 7 on it and do a dual boot of them, because I have done that before. And that's just about the best way you can go. So, not bad. I mean, I'm gonna come back to this later, but I just wanted to have a preliminary look at it. And I don't know how long I've been going for. We've been going for 26 minutes. It's kind of a boring video, but if you're interested in this kind of stuff, there you go. Now the hardest part is getting this back on. If I do a hard drive swap, it's going to be on video too, I think. I should have done a video when I did the whole front piece swap. Or not swap, but rather the drive swap and taking the whole thing apart. But that would have been a long video, or an edited video, so. Because it was quite a process. Because it first involved me trying to disassemble the existing drive and making it work, because if you remember, the drive wouldn't open. But it was also just non-functional, so. It's what it is. But yeah, getting this to line up is not particularly easy. This is the biggest bitch of doing this. It might have a little bit of. Thank God for at least thumb screws. Eh, it's probably good enough. Okay, so that is the HP 552X tower. Interesting investment. I didn't get a whole lot out of this thing. I probably got more out of the monitor than the computer, to be honest, but this actually, because when I got it, it was pretty messed up, because it was not very good with the amount of RAM it had in it, and it had no graphics card, and the operating system install was completely screwed on it, and the DVD and CD drives were dead. So I wasn't particularly pleased with it when I first got it. And that ultimately led me to buying my first iMac, like a week later. Only really a couple days later did I order it, but and that began a whole computer journey that continues to this day. Although I haven't really upgraded my Mac in a while, I'm still using the old 2010 iMac. Which is a legendary computer, to say the least. But, yeah. So that's the HP Pavilion 552X preliminary cleaning. And, hope you all enjoyed this video.